That girl, she crazy.
Day 2, 7 a.m. Candace is still asleep. And I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna go for another run. What's up, guys?
How are you? Great running into you.
Great running into you, both literally and figuratively. Good to see you guys.
See ya.
Good running. Those are some friends. They're also here with the tech delegation. Great guys. That's it. Run is complete. Feel good. Time to start the day.
Wake up. You are so pretty in the morning.
So this is it. This is our last day in Cuba. Short trip. We fly back to Miami at like 5 o'clock today. So we're gonna try to make the most out of the afternoon. It is muggy, sweaty, hot, and overcast out.
I thought you were in charge of all my stuff.
You have everything else. Do you have your passport and your visa?
I think so.
Your visa is $500.
Let's get food here.
Mira la ti, mira la ti.
No.
Your champion, the competition, the veteran, the one culture, the mojito drink.
I'm serious. Want to try one? Okay, well, no.
The guy that Candace was talking to explained to her that he is the Havana mojito champion. So we ordered a mojito for breakfast. He's also just a very good salesman. We got our award-winning mojitos. They're pretty good, right? Can you tell? This could have come out of a can, I wouldn't know the difference. Obligatory Cuban cigar shopping.
$340
for a box. Most expensive. Just get those are fine. Let's go.
Don't do that to me.
You've been here for 35 minutes.
I know, but...
Are you ready? Because the buses are going to leave without us.
They're not leaving without us.
She has been in there for 1 hour. I don't even think she knows anyone that smokes cigars. They have these old cars here because of a trade embargo, I think from 1959. So they can't import US cars after 1959, so all the cars are from before 1959, but they have to keep these things running for the last 60 years. And to do that, they've like completely Frankenstein them together. So like, it looks like a funny old car. Those taillights are from like a 1998 Chevy Lumina.
And they just appropriated them in.
The car culture here probably captured my imagination more so than anything else. We're back on the bus. We're now headed to, I think, Ernest Hemingway's house, something like that. And then we're doing one more thing, and then we leave. We've arrived. It is monsooning outside. Candace stayed on the bus because of course she did. It's raining so hard. This is the only place where there's cover. The gift shop. Yeah, that's wet. That's wet. Ugh. Going to the, it says U.S. Embassy residence now, which sounds interesting. This is the photo shoot situation at the U.S. Ambassador's residence here. We are woefully underdressed. And when I say we, I don't just mean Candace and me. I think we all are a little underdressed to be here right now. This is it. We're back at the airport. We're getting ready to leave Cuba. Is that the other bus? That's it. Our bags are somewhere on that bus. Hey buddy, where are you flying to? Where are you going? All set? Spending the last of our currency on more cigars.
Six.
I'm still not eating sugar, but I'm not on US soil, so technically this does not count. The plane is now an hour and a half late. This is a chartered plane, but the weather is terrible outside. It can't land. We are flying from here to Miami, and then we have a flight from Miami back to New York, where we have to get the baby at midnight. Little update, the flight is now 2 hours late to take off. We're nervous we're not going to make it back in time. And tomorrow morning is Francine's first birthday party, so the stakes are high. Alright, next update. No progress. This terminal has just lost it. It is completely packed in here. No planes have left in a while. This sucks. Something's happening. There's been a lot of noise, but not a lot of movement. Candace started crying. She's worried that she's gonna miss Francine's birthday party. And I think we probably are gonna miss Francine's birthday party. I think they just called their plane.
No, just wanted.
Okay, this is it. We're getting on the bus and then getting on the plane. We're boarding now. You got freaked out?
This is like the beginning of a really bad story.
At least we're on the plane. No one's super psyched right now.
Anyway, so sorry. All right, so thank you guys again for coming to Tech Week Havana, our inaugural international voyage.
For sure.
I cannot even get into internet here.
I know. We had the same issue. We're like, it's Tech Week, but
hey guys, why don't we talk about this in the air? Back in Miami. We're at the Miami International Airport now, waiting for an Uber to pick us up to take us to Fort Lauderdale. So we got a flight at Fort Lauderdale tomorrow morning at 6 to get us into New York City at 8:45, which should have us home in time for the baby's birthday party.
How you doing? So just head towards Fort Lauderdale. We'll put in a specific address as we get closer, okay?
Near the airport.
Thank you. How you doing tonight?
Good. How about you?
Doing well.
Where are you guys coming from?
Cuba.
Cuba?
Cuba.
Really?
Yeah, really. And what kind of a boat did you leave in?
Oh, no, it wasn't a boat. I wish it was a boat. It's a raft. Yes, Rav, we put together five inner tube. Do you know what inner tube is?
Yeah.
You put together five inner tube, tied it with rope, and then just two oaks and paddle for 5 days.
Oh my god.
We switch, we paddle for 2 hours, two, and then we switch, we rest for 5 days.
Paddle. What about food and water?
No food for 3 days, no water for 2 days and a half.
And then where did you land?
I never land. I was found by some American fisherman.
And how do you like life in the United States of America versus life in Cuba?
Oh, come on, this is not comparison. You know, I that's the reason we came here, because we want freedom.
Oh, thank you. Nice to meet you.
Lennon, it was a pleasure.
Hey, pleasure, sir. Thank
nice
you, sir.
To meet you. Have a good night.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
We're at our crappy airport hotel now. But in case you missed the story, that car right there, that driver, our Uber driver, his name was Lennon, he escaped Cuba on an inflatable raft, an inner tube, and they rode from Cuba to the United States of America, where they were rescued. And now he's a citizen here, and he brought his whole family here. And we asked him what he did for a living when he wasn't driving an Uber car. And what he does is he dresses up as a clown and goes to a children's hospital and entertains kids that are sick with cancer. That is what he does here in America after escaping Cuba, the country we were just in. This is how you open up a bottle of wine on an airplane.
Giving